Hey guys, welcome to Modelman Animation. This is the behind the scenes of season 2. In this video, I'm gonna talk about the topics that I used in season 1 and season 2. And also I'm gonna talk about the process and the methods that I used to create the tutorials for season 2. And next, I'm gonna talk about my plans for season 3. So if this is the first time that you come to my channel, you just have to go and check the playlists. So far, I've made 30 tutorials about animation, 10 episodes for season 1 and 20 episodes for season 2. Season 1 is for beginners, so if you don't have any idea of what animation is, you can watch the videos of it. In season 1, you can learn how to work with your mouse and keyboard and learn how to install any software and also solve the bugs when it comes to installing a software. And also I'm gonna talk about the meaning of layers and groups. I also have some videos for those ones who are in a lower intermediate level, so they can learn about perspectives, 12 principles of animation, and how to start working with every graphic software. In season 2, I changed the level of the videos from lower intermediate to upper intermediate, and we're gonna focus on Moho, which is a 2D animation software. Also, you can create 3D objects and, you know, design different kind of animations, and I'm gonna explain every features of it throughout the season. At the beginning of the season, I teach you how to save and use some simple features of the layer window and how to use some tools. And then as we get going, you're gonna learn every feature in every window of Moho, such as all of the options in tools window and also timeline window. One of the reasons that I'm making this video is that rather than the users, also those ones who want to create their own tutorial have a bit of understanding of what actually a good tutorial is. I use 4 methods in my videos that I want to share with you. Method 1. So there are some situations that you want to explain something, and I've seen that some YouTubers do this. They just bring the option and say, okay, this option is gonna do that, the other option is gonna do that, you know? And it's totally wrong, because the person who's watching your video expects to see a kind of understanding, and he tries to comprehend what you're talking about. So I think that it's better to just give them some simple examples, so they have a general idea in what cases, in what kind of situations they can use that specific tool that you're talking about. Method 2, you have to show them when a bug comes, and next, you have to show them how to solve it. So since you're the teacher, you're the professional. Sometimes when you're doing something, when you're teaching something, you're gonna avoid the bugs without thinking about them. But when it comes to your audience, he goes to the software, try to do the same thing, but maybe in different way that he thinks that it works, and then he faces the bug. So in my opinion, a good tutorial teaches you the bugs rather than just teaching you how to work with the software and options and features, you know? Method 3. Your examples should be simple and easy to follow. I've seen that some YouTubers, for their first video especially, they try to create an extraordinary character with a lot of detail, and then they try to rig it and apply that famous head turn of Moho, you know? In other words, they're just showing off, and you only learn how to create that character, how to rig that view of the character. But instead of doing this, if your tutorial is easy to follow, then your audience will understand it, and he also can do the same thing simultaneously while watching your tutorial. And also, because we are focusing on the structure, the foundation of the software, the person who's watching the video can apply the same rules to her or his project. That's why this method can be absolutely helpful. The last method that I use is that my video is in order, like a course, you know? I've seen that some YouTubers start from the favorite and popular topics, and then when somebody asks them in the comment section that what is the answer of this question, they have to go back and make it simple and create another video. And because they are not in order, we have some simple videos at first, then we have some you know, complicated ones, and then again we have some easy ones, and the audience will get confused. On the other hand, if your videos are in order, if somebody asks you a question, you can just share the link of your previous video and say, this is the answer of your question, and he can go and watch it. Now let's talk about my plans for the future. After season 1 and season 2, I'm gonna create two more playlists. The first one is of course the season 3, which we're gonna focus on animating and rigging because it's the right time to teach them. And also, I'm gonna create another playlist called FAQ, stands for Frequently Asked Questions. And for that playlist, I'm gonna choose some of your comments at first and answer every question with a single video, which is gonna be very cool. And I think it helps me to have a bit of interaction with my subscribers. So from now on, if you write a comment in the comment section of my tutorial, I will definitely check them and maybe I will choose them for my FAQ playlist and try to answer them in a single video. Of course, with your username mentioned in the video and a screenshot of your question. If you wonder how I'm creating these tutorials for you, to record the videos, I use Camtasia. I edit my videos in Adobe Premiere Pro. The outro of season 2 was created using Adobe After Effects. And the intro and outro songs of season 2 was actually a remix of the movie Interstellar, which you probably have watched it. And that's it guys, you know that I need your support, so don't forget to subscribe, like and share, and see you in the next season.